Can we fix the exposure while flying? There we go. Okay. So we are at the Penguin Club, as you can probably tell. And we are, today we are going to be doing some testing with the new fuel and checking different compression ratios on the model. This is just a test flight to make sure that everything is okay. But if you look to the side here, then you'll be able to see some of the tests we want to do. I'll be using the same prop, same glow plug, same everything throughout these tests. I'll only be changing the compression volume. So let's see how this goes.
So with a pretty clear plan for what to do this day at the model flying club, let's put on an engine. And this is an old 2012 engine. I'll use this one because this is the one I have the most recent data on the compression volume. For the propeller for these tests, I'll be using a TS prop, and I know these props comes in different versions. So this is the one that is 156. And I'll be using that prop for all the tests. Of course, for just to keep everything consistent, I'll be adding in a brand new glow plug. So before any of you guys comment on it, yes, this is indeed a Swedish fleeced shirt. The reason I'm using this one is because all my other fleece shirts are too nice, and this is the only one I want to get dirty. So the fuel I'll be using for this test is this one, with 15% ML70 and 5% nitro. So it's the correct blend, and it's pure synthetic. It's an ML70 oil, whatever that means. So no castor oil in this one. So we're almost ready to go outside. There's a nice little box with a model and everything we need. But there's another important thing that we have to take out there, and that's this. I swear, I can't survive without this stuff. See, this model has been severely patched up and the miler is loose in several places. So it's probably not the fastest model. So the absolute time for 10 laps is not actually showing what the correct value is. But since we're just comparing laps, then it shouldn't matter that much. I can see for each time I take a shim out, I get slightly more RPM, slightly more RPM. Remember kids, the difference between science and screwing around is writing things down. So, we are now at a point with the engine where there's only one thin shim left inside. I don't want to take that out because I think it actually works as a gasket as well. Let's get some more fuel and then do a range check. So we'll run the engine on the ground for 30 seconds, like in a normal heat, and then I'll go up and fly some maneuvers. We'll time everything and then see when we run out of fuel. 70 milliliters of fuel. Now we're flying. Ah, something is changing in the engine now. Interesting. That's interesting. Let's see what the video says. I'll put the time up here. That's the time for 70 milliliters. And by calculating, then we can see how much we actually need for 4 minutes on screen now. That's some data for you there. So that's it for this time around. Use the data as you want, but don't hold me responsible. I suggest you go out and do your own tests. I think there is something to be gained from increasing the compression volume within the engine. And I found that it doesn't actually change the RPM that much, but it changes a lot more in the speed and the maneuvers. The flying speed didn't change that much, RPM didn't change that much, but speed and the maneuvers changed a lot. But again, I suggest you go out and find your own data. That's it for now. Please leave a like if you like this video, and if you have any comments or experience or any ideas on what we can do with the new fuel rules and how we should set up the engines, then please comment down below. Also, if you have ideas for videos and changes that you want to see on this channel, then please, by all means, comment. I would like some feedback. See you in the next video. Bye for now. Roadblock is still fine. It doesn't sound like it's... trying to record audio over here, what the hell? As I was saying, I was taking four shims out.